Hello everyone and welcome to another Fantasy Grounds Unity video. In this video, I'm going to show you how to put a grid on a tactical map. So first thing we want to do is find a map to put a grid on, and in the right hand corner of your Unity interface, go to the images sidebar button, and I want to add a grid to my Underworld Market map. So I want to click on that, and now I have my map in front of me. So to open up the map and utilize all of the different map making tools, in the upper right hand corner, go ahead and click on the locked symbol and it will unlock the map. And you'll notice here on the right hand side, all of the new Unity map tools are going to appear for you. And you can resize this window as large or small as you want by using the drag handle, like what I'm doing now, or you can just hold down control and anywhere in the interface, you can resize it that way as well. So I want to add a square grid to this map. And what I like to do is beforehand, I like to resize my maps. So I like all of my maps to translate into every one of these squares equaling 100 pixels by left to right and 100 pixels from top to bottom. So it would be a 100 by 100 pixel grid. So I've already resized this map. You can use any kind of tool like Photoshop, GIMP, Paint.net, and then there's a lot of other online utilities that you can use in your browser as well. So once I've got my map selected, I've got the map tools opened up. You can go ahead and just, I'd like to zoom in to get a better look at the grid. And I'll find one spot, preferably in the middle of the map. And then you can right click, and then the radial menu will pop up, and then click on the layers button, and then another menu will pop up, and then you set your grid. And when you click on that, now you can set your grid, and you'll see where my highlighted mouse is. You'll see a little square box on the star pointer, and I like to get in the middle of all of the grids. And I know this is going to be around 100 to 100, and you just simply drag it across. And then in the upper right hand corner, you'll notice that in the very upper right hand corner of the Unity interface, you'll see that the numbers are kind of adjusting on how big your grid is getting. So I know this is 100 by 100, so I can see that now it says 100.0 by 100.0, and my grid should be perfect. Yeah, look at that. I don't even have to nudge it or realign it or anything. And that's simply because after working with Fantasy Grounds for so long, and when you get maps, a lot of times maps aren't resized, you know, the way that you want it. And then you just fight and struggle on getting a grid on a map. So that's why I always like to resize my maps to 100 by 100. But if you do not resize your map, and if you put a grid, and then you'll notice that the grid kind of loses its oomph, and then it starts to overlap into the other grid squares, you can do a couple of things. You can adjust the numbers and manipulate the numbers up top here in the upper right hand corner until the grid actually fits to where you want it to. And then you can also see that there is an adjust position tool here to where when I zoom in, if I nudge it to the right, you can see that the grid moves to the right one pixel at a time, and then it moves left one pixel at a time. Now there's some smaller arrows as you can see, and instead of being one pixel, it is a 0.1 pixel adjust. So you can even do that much more of a finer grid adjustment. So definitely, if you can't get the grid to line up, I would definitely use the adjust position, and you may have to resize the map a couple of different times, or just save yourself a bunch of time and just resize it to 100 by 100 squares. And how you do that, you just basically count the number of squares across on the map. So, you know, if there's, let's see, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28, 30. I know that there's 30 grids, and that's going to be 30 times 100, which is 3,000. So my image damage is going to be 3,000 across, and then it's 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So 19 squares down, 20 squares down would be 2,000. So this image, as a file, after I'm resizing it, will be 3,000 by 2,000. So, and if you don't want to do 100 by 100 pixel grids, you can also do 50 by 50. I know a lot of fellow GMs that I talk to, they do 50 by 50. So, you know, then you would just basically multiply 30 by 50 and 20 by 50. So it's really easy to get those resized. And like I said, you can do all that on paint.net, Photoshop, GIMP, whatever, you know, image tool that you're using. So another couple things with the grid options that you have or features that are new to Fantasy Grounds Unity is whenever you have your map unlocked, you have the tools here showing, this is where everything's stored for line of sight, you know, lighting, everything. The very far right, there is a grid, and it looks exactly what it is. That's a grid tool. And this is, like I said, this is where all of your information is going to be stored, 100 by 100 pixels. You can make sure there's a little eyeball here. You can toggle this on and off to show the grid or not to show the grid. You can also choose a different grid type. So if you're doing any kind of isometric stuff, here is a triangular grid for you if you're doing ISO. And then here are a couple of different hexagons to where if you're going to be doing Starship Combat and Starfinder or any other game that uses the hex grid system, then here are the two different types of grids you would use for those maps. And you would basically do the same thing by right-clicking, going to your layers, and then turning your grid on and off that way, and then setting the actual grid lines themselves. You can also change the color of your grid if you want to. And by default, it's going to be a very light ghostly white. But if you want, you can open this up and just click anywhere around in this color spectrum. And as you can see, the grid is changing colors to wherever I'm going. Or you can use the alphanumeric code down there at the bottom. Or there's also a little color picking tool that you can use. So once you get the color of the grid that you want, all you would do would just be to hit OK and you'll be good to go. So down here, I also want to show you a couple of cool things that you can do with the grid as well. I've already talked to you about the adjust position, which is a great tool to nudge left or right. Now there is a distance multiplier. Now this means that every one of these squares is going to represent 5. And the suffix is going to be, does it equal feet? Does it equal yards? Does it equal miles, etc.? Now by default, the grid is going to be 5 feet. But if you have other maps that are going to say, hey, one grid is 10 feet, then you can do that as well just by simply clicking in the distance grid modifier box and just typing and putting 10 in there. So now every one of these grid squares are going to be 10 feet instead of 5 feet. So I'll kind of show you what I'm talking about. So you need to go into play mode up here in the upper right hand corner in your map tools interface. Now, what I mean by this is you can hold down both the left and right mouse click button, and you can drag, and you can see that these 6 squares are now at a value of 60 feet. All right. So that's a nice measuring tool for your players to use or you to use as a DM to say, okay, this orc or this character is X feet away, you're within range of your arrow or your spell, or you have that much movement to move towards that creature or NPC that you may be attacking as a GM. So it's a great tool. And like I mentioned, just hold down the left and the right mouse button at the same time and just drag it down. And you can do this diagonal as well, as you can see. And depending on the rule set that you're using, it will take the +5, +10, yards or feet or whatever that you're doing. Like if you're playing Pathfinder first edition, Or maybe D&D 3.5, where the first square is 5 feet and then 10 feet, 5 feet, 10 feet. So it, the measuring tool will take that into consideration as well. But this is D&D 5e, and everything is just 5 feet, as you can see. But as we have it translated in our settings, it is 10 feet. So I'm gonna do this here. This is worth 70 feet, should be 7 squares, which it is. And if I want to change this around, this the numbering and also the little feet symbol here, I can do that. And just simply go back into your grid. And if I want to change it back to 5 feet, I can do that. And now it will show as 35 feet, as you can see. Now, if I want to get rid of this little, you know, little comma for a distance suffix, and if I want to type feet in there, I can do that. And as you can see, now it says 35 feet instead of 35 comma, which comma means feet anyway. And then there's also a raw distance that you can turn on and off that will put it into a decimal number for you. And that's pretty much everything that you need to know about setting a grid on a combat tactical map. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Hope you learned something from this. So feel free to leave a comment down below. And also, if you like the video, do me a huge favor, give me a thumbs up, and also subscribe to the YouTube channel and click that bell notification. Every time I release a video, you will get notified. So until next video, happy gaming and stay safe.